In Burnaby Lake Regional Park, an old pedestrian bridge over Still Creek needed replacement, which might seem like a simple project. But the sensitive ecosystem in the area presented some unique issues.
Whenever we build something in a regional park, we have to be cognizant that it's connected to nature. And because of that, we need to take precautions to protect the species and systems that are in place in our parks so that the development doesn't impact them to any great extent.
For this bridge, every factor that we looked at had a challenge.
The main problem was soft, marshy soil in the area, which is made up of sandy silt and peat.
The soil itself meant that we couldn't bring in a lot of heavy equipment to install the bridge, and we couldn't bring in the heavy equipment to put in the piles.
Heavy gear would have also damaged the ecosystem, so a different solution was found.
By using a helicopter to lift the bridge into place, we didn't need to fortify any roadways for cranes, and we didn't need to take more trees down to allow access for a large crane.
This is the first time that Metro Vancouver Regional Parks has installed a bridge by helicopter, so we just determined that as light of a bridge as possible would be necessary, and aluminum is a very light material, so that's why aluminum was chosen. The weight of the new bridge is 10,000 pounds, and that is considerably lighter than the existing bridge.
Demolition of the old bridge began soon after the helicopter installation. Environmental protection measures included setting live traps for the endangered Pacific water shrew, but only deer mice were found. They were relocated away from the bridge zone. Silt fences were installed to keep sedimentation from the project out of Still Creek.
Here at Still Creek, it is a fish-bearing stream, and because the fish are here, we need to take precautions to not impact the water quality through sediment and erosion control.
In the end, careful planning not only minimized environmental impact to Burnaby Lake Regional Park, it also resulted in a more durable structure.
Our usual construction methods give a bridge a 20-year lifespan. This bridge will have a 40-plus year lifespan. We could probably look at no maintenance on the bridge itself for the first 10 to 20 years. So I'm looking forward to that.